The first lesson is taken from the prophet Isaiah. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. Yet they made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich, although he had done no violence, and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring and shall prolong his days. Through him the will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish we shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore I will allot him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured himself to death. And he was numbered with the transgressors, yet he bore the sin of many and made the intercession for the transgressors. The word of the Lord. We will say the psalm alternating by whole verse. Because you have made the Lord your refuge and the Most High your habitation, for he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. You shall tread upon the lion and adder. You shall trample the young lion and the serpent under your feet. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I am with him in trouble. I will rescue him and bring him to honor.
A reading from the New Testament, from the book of Hebrews. Every high priest chosen from among mortals is put in charge of things pertaining to God on their behalf, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal gently with the ignorant and wayward. Since he himself is subject to weakness, and because of this, he must offer sacrifice for his own sins, as well as for those of the people. And one does not presume to take this honor, but takes it only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not glorify himself in becoming a high priest, but was appointed by one who said to him, "You are my son. Today I have begotten you." As he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered, and having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Having been designated by God a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with my spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to him and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And he said to them, "What is it you want me to do for you?" And they said to him, "Grant us to sit, one on your right hand and one on your left, in your glory." But Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" They replied, "We are able." Then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink. And with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or at my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those who has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those who are recognized as their leaders lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you, for whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
Bringing all that we have and all that we are to the altar of God, let us offer our prayers and thanksgivings. Guard your church from being rich in things but poor in soul. Calm our hearts as we work to employ your gifts in building your kingdom. Strengthen our leaders, especially Michael, our presiding bishop, Sean, our presiding bishop-elect, and Kevin, our bishop. And give us all a share in your holy work. God of every blessing, inspire the leaders of the nations to use their power to bring dignity to all people. Guide our president, our governor, and our mayor to be agents of your justice and mercy, and to awaken in all of us a faithful concern for the creation that has been put into our hands. God of every blessing, enliven the communities in which we work, learn, and serve. Watch over those near and far away who serve and protect us, especially those we name now, aloud or in our hearts. Surround them and us in your holy angels, and lead all your hearts to love others as you love us. God of every blessing, sustain our partners in mission, especially Anglais American de Rwanda and St. Barnabas Church, Wilmington. Remind them and us that your plans for the world are beyond all that we can ask or imagine, and move us to work together in prayer and action. God of every blessing, pour thankfulness into the hearts and into our lives. Help us to see the abundance that surrounds us. Free us from worry and doubt, and enable us all to live lives of generosity. God of every blessing, comfort those in any need or trouble, especially those we name now, aloud or in our hearts. Heal them with your love and mercy. Restore and renew whatever is broken in our souls and our common life as your household, and give us all a share in your compassion. God of every blessing, give rest to all the faithful departed, especially those we name now, aloud or in our hearts. Open our eyes to see that they worship with us in your congregation that surpasses all time and space, and bring us all to share with them at your table in heaven. God of every blessing, God of every blessing, we come before you strong in faith, with our hearts overflowing with thankfulness. Pour into this in the spirit of abundance. Remind us that we have only ways in your glory, what we might do for the work of your church, or your testimony. Guide us as we make our choices, that we will help build your kingdom now and forever, and sustain us always in the promise and gift of Christ. In your presence among us, in his name we pray.
Thank you. is very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy.
Thank you.
Alleluia, Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
We says in the book they gave me, this is time for announcements, it also says that the announcements are all printed in the booklet that you're going to take home with you, not leaving the pew. So, but are there any announcements that we should make? Any special Sheila, Mark, that we should make? Got one.
Remain with you always.
Amen.
to love and serve the Lord.